Why the fire?
Right, I'll tell you. While the one phrase, Kanava, what she says, a family woman, if that woman is having good chastity, she has to accept the death. When, if she loses her husband, immediately she has to die. That is the phrase given by the queen. Because I lost my husband right now, so I do not want to live. So I wanted to die immediately. So you can't match the husband with any relationship in this world. So by way of telling this phrase, Kannaki got wild. Because yesterday I lost my husband, so I have not died in the yesterday. As long as I am maintaining my life for a day, and because of that only you are saying I am not having the chastity. It is wrong. I am here to prove my husband is not guilty. For that purpose only I am here. It doesn't mean I am not having chastity. If you are going to accept this, I am not going to allow this mother-in-law. That's why he says, Pattangil yamor patiniye amahil. In this world, if I were be accepted by the people as the chastityful woman, I will not allow this mother to live. So then, because it's a provocation. The queen of the Pandya queen provocated Kannaki. If she would have not given any statement on that provocation side, Kannaki would have left that incident as it is. This is the major.
The queen provoked in form of her action of dying, or actually does she also speak?
She mentioned that phrase. Kanavanai ilandorukku kaattuvathu onriyil. She mentioned. In a family woman's life, the husband is the main person. If he dies, automatically the woman also has to die. She was telling to Kannaki. And dead. That made Kannaki not to allow this mother. So, if you want to analyze the character in Silapadigaram, every character is a very beautiful character. You can analyze and enjoy. That's why I used to say, normally, if you are going to write a very big epic or very big story, automatically you may get one or two flaw statement, one or two flaw areas. But whereas in Silapadigaram, it is not at all having any flaws. That is the beauty of Silapadigaram. And he is not only telling the story. Every chapter, what are the other things have to be told. It is nicely, very nicely woven by Ilangavadi. While they were crossing the Puga, he is telling about the wealth of the Puga. He is talking about the markets in Puga. And what are the things sold in Puga? Pearls were sold, people were selling the pearls, diamonds, and he started to tell them how to identify the good diamond, how to identify the good pearl. All these things he is giving in detail. As such, there, if you want to read that area, automatically you may think Ilangavadigal is a diamond merchant. No, immediately people will come to that conclusion. He is giving all the technical nuances of diamond checking, all the nuances of ruby checking. What are the method to check a ruby? He is giving all the details. Then if he is going to talk about the musical instrument, he is giving the pakka details of the musical instrument. How the flute is supposed to be made. What is the lyre? How the people are making the lyre? What is mridangam, tannumai? And what is the quality and grammar for manufacturing a mridangam? Everything he is giving in detail. If he is going to talk about the dance theater, A to E that he is giving about the dance gate. Just like that, Madhavi did her dance while she was doing her arangetam, that is enough for him. In that chapter, he is talking when you are going to start to learn the dance. What is the right age? Even today we are following. Even today, we are all taking the students only in the age of 6. So, then, at the age of 6, they have to start the dance. Up to 12 years, they have to learn and practice the dance. At the age of 13, they have to show their talent on the stage. This is the system still we are following. And what are the hand gestures? what are the nirthasthas, what are the abhinayasthas, all the details which are related to dance is giving in detail. In Achiyar Kuravai, you can go and see the details of music. How to form a music, what are the main swaras, you know, there are 24 pitches in the world music. All the 24 pitches rightly mentioned by Ilangoa Vadigal. Ilangoa Vadigal's work is the first and the foremost work on music about the pitches. So 24 Shrutis, the Aadhaara Shruti is 24. It is rightly mentioned by Ilangoa Vadigal. It is a unique detail about music because my father-in-law, Dr. S. Ramanathan, did his PhD only on Silapadigaram. Silapadigaram and music, that is his PhD. That book actually, Music in Silapadigaram, it is published in English and as well as in Tamil. Silapadigarathisai Nunutka Vilakkam, that Tamil book also available in the market. So his entire research is on Silapadigaram. How Ilangoa Vadigal was exposing the musical details in Silapadigaram. In addition to that, he proved Silapadigaram is the first and the foremost book which deals and which proves the 22 Shrutis in the music. There he is giving lot of details. So, how Ilangoa Vadigal came to know all the details, that's a wonder. That's a wonder.
In fact, that was a question for me, sir. Are you sure it is only one person who has written all of this?
Definitely one person, because we are knowing the diction and we are having the continuity of words, right? Continuity of words. Because by way of reading one or two chapters, this is the way how the Ilangoa Vadigal presenting the subject matter. Every chapter, the same technique is followed. So you can't hear one technique by way of reading one or two chapters and start to write like him. It is not at all possible. Automatically you will get caught after writing one or two chapters. It is not yours. You are copying from somebody's work. But it is not so. It is having a very clear-cut detail. Very clear-cut detail. So whatever the idea, whatever the subject he wants to deal, he is giving more and more details in depth. That is the beauty. Even for example, he is talking about the dance stage, how the lamps have to be set. He is giving one particular quote for that. The performer's shade not supposed to be fall on the audience. In that way, you have to keep the lamp on the stage. It means you have to keep the lamps on the four corners having the same intensity. If the lamps are having the same intensity, then it will not make any shadows. See the beauty. So he says, Nadana Mada Kudiyabali Nudiya Nijal audience la Vadakuda. Because if the dancer's shade falls on the audience, means audience may not be able to see the dancer's abhinaya. So she is talking about how the lights have to be kept. Every small details of even how to start the dance he is giving in detail. Initially the musicians will come and say where they have to sit. And in what order they have to sit. The first the vocalist, behind the vocalist the flutist, behind the flutist the lyre player, behind the lyre player the mridangam player, then after the mridangam player other percussionist have to sit. Kural vadi nindradu kulale, kulal vadi nindradu yaale, yaal vadi nindradu tannumai, tannumai vadi nindrana pevigai. This is the method you have to arrange it on the stage, because in those days there was no mic. There was no amplifier. You have to balance your music through your voice only. So before the dance program, you have to sing for 30 to 40 minutes. He is mentioning the time also. Because the senior dancers, the retired dancers, they are used to sing. Their name is known as Doriya Madandaya. Doriya Madandaya means long back there are the dancers. After getting their retirement, they used to sing only. A set of Doriya Madandaya will appear on the stage along with the music team. And the dancer also have to appear on the stage, have to sing for 30 to 40 minutes. Then only they form the warm-up. Warm-up and all the srutis will be set into one form. Because every instrument is having different sruti, they have to. Nowadays we are having the sruti balancing meters and so on. In those days it was not there. They have to sing and retune it, sing and retune. That's the system. So for that purpose they have to sing for 30 to 40 minutes. After only, and how the dance has to be started. First of all, the dancer have to praise the Lord. If it is the daytime, she or he has to praise the sun god. If it is in the evening time, the dancers have to praise the moon. Then four kautuvas, that is called Nalvagai Bhudam Padi. Then they have to sing a song on Mayon, a god of protection. Then they have to start the program. These three things are compulsory. Nila Padi, Nalvagai Pudam Padi, Mayon Pani Padi. All these things are invocatory. After the invocatories only, they have to start the main item. That is a compulsory. So, what Madhavi did, everything is rightly mentioned. And he says, while you are doing the Nirtha Hasta, you are not supposed to do any Abhinaya Hasta. While you are doing some Abhinaya, don't put the Nirtha Hasta in that Abhinaya.
Sir, with reference to the order of the orchestra's arrival or seating, or with reference to these dance rules, am I to understand that he wrote what was happening in practice? He observed and he wrote.
Exactly.
So his book, the Shilapadikara, is a documentation of the society, the practice, the tradition and culture that lived during that time period.
Exactly. It is a bundle, or it is a museum of the past. The museum of the past Tamil society. I can say the Shilapadikaram, that one book is enough to know the details of the past Tamilians or past Dravidians culture. The one book is enough.
But even then, it's so difficult to believe that it is done by one person, sir. How can someone do both?
Oh, it is quite easy. I will tell you one thing. Because he was a crown prince of Chera kingdom, Ilangobadigai. Then he is not interested in ruling. So he given up and becoming a Buddhist saint and came to the literature side. It is quite easy for a person to know about the subject. There are people are there. They will come and give the details. For example, even today, a poet is going to write something about a new subject. He is reading the subject. It is available in the market. Nowadays, even it is quite easy. In the website, in the Google, we can get all the things, everything. In those days, people used to send. A poet wants to know something, he will go and approach the right person or a proper person. He will come and tell the details. So after gaining and getting all the details, he will be putting in poetry form, that's all. So one thing. Second thing, he may be having the individual taste toward the music and dance. One, he is getting the proper information and instruction from others, or he by himself having some taste in that. It's not wrong. So that is the beauty. Even now, he is having the cogence in his writing. That is the beauty. Because all the 30 chapters are having cogence. There's no flaw in the chapters. There is no, the connection between the chapters are very finely linked. Very finely linked. That is the beauty of that literature. That's why I used to admire Ilangobadigal's writing. Because 2000 years back, how he was able to see and visualize the entire story. Even he is writing the literature after hearing the full story, that is different. Even then, he visualized everything in poetry form. And what to say in the first and what will be the second, what will be the third. Everything he arranged in his mind and put it in a neat order. That's the most important thing of Ilangobadigal. Even for example, nowadays the students are writing 3 pages composition. It is not having any proper connection. what they are saying in the first paragraph, it is not getting connected to the second paragraph. But in 30 beautiful stories, 30 chapters,
how many songs, sir, in the 30 chapters?
No, every chapter is a long verse. It's a long verse, every chapter. Only after the Tirthakathevar, we are having the four-line songs. I already told you in Kambaramayanam class. So before that, Manimegalai and Chindamani, before Chindamani, Manimegalai and Sarapadigaram, every chapter is a long verse.
Around how many lines will be there in each?
It may vary. Some of the chapters are having 120 lines. Some of them are 85 lines. Because what he wants to tell in that chapter, according to that, he is rearranging the lines.
So it's actually not very long. It's quite concise and edited, well edited.
Well edited. Right. You can't even take a single word in that book. Such a package, such a beautiful package in a Titan form he is giving it, the details.
And how
that is the beauty of Ulangavadi.
How do you discuss? In manuscript form, do we actually have...
Long back it was in the palm leaf script. Generationally, it passed it on to the people. When Uwe Swaminarayar wanted to publish this Sirapadigaram, he traveled widely in Tamil Nadu. He found 14 different scripts on Sirapadigaram. 14 different palm leaf scripts. Then he matched all the things. Finally, he found a script which only he got it from Midilaipatti in Tenneral district. That one is giving more and more details. Then that's the most important thing. This Sirapadigaram in original and two people's commentary. One is 10th century commentary, Arumbada Urayasriya. 12th century commentary is Adiyar Kanallar. Even in that Adiyar Kanallar commentary, we don't get everything is intact. Some of the chapters we lost. His commentary we are not having full. Some of the chapters we lost. With all that, Uwe Swaminarayar published his entire work by way of having the comparative study with all the manuscripts, and finally he came to this is the original and he published it. So the book is very beautiful work. That's the beauty of it, because even after 2000 years, still we are finding lot of treasure in Sirapadigaram. Even people are still doing lot of research in Sirapadigaram. So not only the characters, even people are talking to how the words he is using, all these the dictions, how he is syntaxing it, everything is analyzed in a meticulous manner. People are going on conducting lot of research on books. So if you are going to ask me to talk about Sirapadigaram, I will talk every chapter for months together. So my problem is the English is a problem. If you are going to ask me to talk in Tamil, I can talk and talk and talk. So Sirapadigaram, I will be completing the Sirapadigaram. It will take me for 2 years to complete. To teach. Well, I am telling in English, I may not be able to get the proper word in English. But whereas in Tamil, it is my own ground.
At every stage, the whole story is told only by the Silamba?
Yeah, that is the reason. It is named after Sirapadigaram. Because of that anklet only the story is narrated. So it is called the Sirapadigaram. Silambu Adigaram, Sirapadigaram.
And the Silamba was a wedding gift to
That is another different story. Because they are all belonging to the business group. What we call as Chettiar community. Chettiars were the business people. So in those days, the anklet, the people, the girls used to wear before marriage. They are not supposed to wear the anklet after the marriage. Before marriage, they have to wear the anklet. After the marriage, what will happen? They will remove the anklet and put meti. Still, the people are conducting that particular event, particular ritual in the Chettiar family of Chettinadu. That is called Silambu Kali Nonbu. Silambu means anklet, Kali means removal, Nonbu means a sacred day. After the marriage, they will find a sacred day or an auspicious day. In that day, they will remove the anklet from that woman and they will add the meti. So that is nowadays known as a Sika Nombu. Silambu Kali Nombu completely lost its order, and people used to say a Sika Nombu. Even now they are practicing it. So even that is the reason what the Golusu and that all, we are not, the married women are not supposed to wear. Nowadays we are just removing all the rules and regulation, because if you are going to wear that metti or silambu, while you are having that metti, by way of hearing the sound, the people will understand a married woman is coming. So they will not see at their face. Instead of not having that metti wali, then if they are having that anklet sound, automatically a young teenage girl is coming across. So automatically they wanted to see. That was the social culture, that was the practice in the past. Through the ornament, they used to inform the people. Wow, even why we are having lot of bangles at the time of Valaigappu and Seemantham. Why that pregnant lady is wearing a lot of bangles? Because she was not able, or she is not able to walk fastly. Every step is a measured one. So every time she is moving her hands, she will, the bangles will make sound. Automatically, people will understand some pregnant woman is coming. They wanted to give the way immediately to her. That is the purpose. One thing, why they are wearing lot of glass bangles, by way of having the glass bangles, automatically the person will understand how gently she has to move. If she is moving fastly, the bangle will get cut. So she wants to maintain the bangle. So in order to maintain the bangle, she has to move in a gentle manner. That will be a help. Helpful thing to the baby in the womb. All these details are given in reason. So, that's why I'm saying this. If Silapadi Garam is not a literature, if you go through the literature in a thorough manner, you can find the details of the past, the 2000 year old history, the 2000 year old social culture. I already mentioned you, it is a museum of the past. The traditional Dravidian people's museum is Silapadi Garam. You can find a lot and lot more of details intact. One for Noma?
Very clear, sir. Two very quick questions.
Right.
One sentence I have to answer. Sir, you said 1,008 gold coins per day. Did he actually pay that for every day that he stayed?
That much wealth he was having.
Good gracious.
No, even that's the reason. I'll tell you one. I think where you are to find the details, by way of introducing the Kovalan's father in the first chapter, how he, Ilangavadigal says, Varunidhi Pirarukku Aarkum Irunidhi Kizhavan Magan. He is having the wealth through the sea trade and as well as the land trade. Irunidhi. Two type of income. Internal business, the land business, and the external business from foreign. So he is having huge wealth. With the help of that wealth, he can buy a kingdom. Even Kannagi's anklet, the rubies in her anklet, with the help of that ruby, we can buy a city. What Ilangavadigal says, that the wonderful rubies are there. So even Kovalan and Kannagis are getting married. How the marriage is conducted by the people, what Ilangavadigal says, Arasu Yelundador Padi Yelundar. If the two kings are going to do the marriage alliance, that much crowd was there in the Kannagi and Kovalan's marriage. They are the richest people in the city. Even another research book by Dr. Raghunathan, Ilangavadigal Yar. That is a book in Tamil. In that he says, Silapadi Garam, it is a book on the ruler and the business people's warfare. The business people wanted to prove they are superior than the kings. And kings wanted to prove that they are the superior than the business people. So it is the type of war.
It's a clash. It's a clash.
Between the two communities, what he says.
Sure. So you mentioned three or four occasions when the men are fine to go to another woman. What about the women, sir?
See, annik women population less. Society lower kelvi varum. When the women population is higher than the men, automatically the social culture will accept the polygamy. Likewise, if the women population is lesser than the men's population, sociology is accepting the polyandry. Draupadi got married with 5 husbands. They are having the literature. So it is accepted. So, see, anything and everything based on the social culture of the past. That's why I already told you, don't measure the past with the help of the present yardstick. It is not at all possible.
Sure.
Right.
Very clear. So I think we can definitely finish for today.
I am already 5:30.
Sorry, thank you, but...
That's the Shilapadigaram is like that only. If I am going to talk on Shilapadigaram, I will not see the clock.
Sir, I have to
see the calendar.